Welcome to another episode of Hardcat Feature Focus. In this episode, we're going to showcase the Purchasing Modules Purchase Order Template feature. To access the Purchasing Modules templates, we first of all go to Modules, Purchasing. From here, we can then go Configuration. Here we are provided with the Purchase Order Templates function. To open that up, we click on the Purchase Order Templates, which then provides us a list via our grid screen of all the templates that have been created in the system. What a template allows you to do is have predefined information around a potential purchase order. Because with our template, we can predefine a contact within the organization, your supplier details, where you want it delivered, the method of delivery, the work group associated, so which, based around the security groups within your Hardcat system, who can see what purchase order templates, your payment terms, any basic more text information, a general description, and then we can go through and enter in the items that we want to be associated to that purchase order line detail. For example, if it's a standing order for workstations, PCs, and printers, we can add those line entries in. We can then go through and populate the tax information, quantities, default warranty period, base unit prices, more text information, as well as delivery details or crate on delivery functionality. We can also go through and apply preset classes to our purchase order template, which will be inherited based around our purchase order. This will allow for an extra 10,000 questions to be asked on a purchase order when raised. To create a new purchase order template, it's as simple as pressing New, or we can go Copy. If we just do a new one from scratch, we'd go New. From here, we can then select all our information as we saw in our previous screen, selecting a contact. So in this instance, it could be Dan Drum. We can specify who we're buying these particular items from by clicking the Supply button, and then selecting our supplier from our listing. If the supplier doesn't exist, we can select them from the list. The other thing we also can mention about a supplier is if they are authorized or not. Because with the authorization function, we can restrict purchase orders to be only raised against suppliers that have been authorized. We can now also mention where we are delivering the item to. So deliver to, in this instance, we'll deliver it to the New South Wales Sydney head office. This purchasing template will be for IT equipment and services. We can now also say we're going to get this by a road delivery. We pay on a 7-day term, and only people within the Sydney area are allowed to see this particular purchase order template. We can now go through and add purchase items to our template. We can go New and select our product. We can either select product from here, or we could simply just type in descriptions into our description area. So this is for 5 PCs. It has 10% VAT assigned to this, which gives us our unit price and then our extended price based around our quantities. With every PC purchased, we'd like some services included. So in this instance, we'd like a telephone service, but not the billing. We would like the PC installation service. This PC installation service per PC costs $50, and it's going to have a 10% GST or VAT assigned. We can now go press OK to select our PC installation service and choose 5 as our default amount. We can go OK to save this. We've also set up that record as being a non-created entity because it is a service, not an asset. We can also include stock items to be included in our purchase order template as well, because you may have accessories or cables that need to be included. So we can go New, select our product, and select Stock. Under Electrical, could be batteries, globes, etc. But if there's a PC power cable that we may need, with a buy price of $5 per cable, and with a tax of 10%. We'd like this to be created when it gets generated, so therefore we're going to select the stock type of electrical and new one, electrical cables. So now we're going to create stock on delivery as well, and we're going to associate it to our stock item. So which means now on this purchase order template, we're going to be receiving 5 PCs, 5 installation services, and then 5 cables as well. We can now press OK to save this template. As we can see now, we can see our IT equipment and services purchase order template. Just going to quickly change the spelling to make it correct. Now we have this template available to us, we can now use this to create work orders off. With this template now created, we can now use this to create purchase orders based around this template type. We can change our area from purchase order templates to be purchase orders. We can create a new purchase order. And we can create it from our IT equipment services template. And by selecting that, as you can see, we now have a purchase order information generated with an order number assigned, order date, delivery information, and our information assigned as per our purchase order template. If we press OK, a new unconfirmed purchase order is created, ready for an authorized person to confirm it. Thank you for watching this episode of Hardcat Feature Focus. If you have any other questions about the Hardcat purchase order templates, feel free to contact Hardcat Support at support@hardcat.com or the sales team at sales@hardcat.com. Thank you very much.